Earth, Moon, and the Sun. I hope you have drawn a beautiful picture of the solar system. If you have not drawn, I think it's the right time to draw it. Now we have reached the end part of this lesson. Only we are left with two concepts, asteroids and meteoroids. We'll discuss one by one. First is the asteroids. You will see a picture on the left side, looks like a rock. Now, in a solar system, apart from the stars, planets, and satellites, there are numerous tiny bodies which also move around the sun. These bodies are called asteroids. They are found between the orbits of Mars and Jupiter. The earlier picture should explain it very clearly. Now, scientists believe that these asteroids are formed when the planets exploded many years back, and they are just the tiny pieces of the planets. Now, the meteoroids, the small pieces of rocks which move around the sun, are called meteoroids. Sometimes these meteoroids come near the Earth and tend to drop upon it. So when this process happens, when the meteoroids get going to Earth, they enter the atmosphere, and due to friction with the air, they get heated up and burn. So it causes a flash of light. Now, you might have seen in a lot of films about the meteoroids striking the Earth, where we launch missiles to decimate it. Sometimes a meteor, without being completely burnt, falls on the Earth and creates a hollow. Now, do you see whitish broadband, like a white glowing path across the sky on a clear starry night? Now we'll see in the picture. It is a cluster of millions of stars. Now all we know is Sun is a star which is nearest to us, and I told you yesterday to find out the second nearest star to the Earth. Some of you answered that is Proxima Centauri. Now this band is the Milky Way galaxy. It is called galaxy, the cluster of millions of stars. In ancient India, it was imagined to be a river of light flowing in the sky. Thus, it was named as Akash Ganga. A galaxy is a huge system of billions of stars and clouds of dust and gases. Our galaxy is Akash Ganga or Milky Way. There are millions of such galaxies that make the universe. So the universe is the bigger one. And the universe is ever expanding. It is difficult to imagine how big the universe is. Scientists are still trying to find out more and more about it. We are not certain about its size, but we know that all of us, you and I, belong to this universe. We are a part of this universe. Now, if you believe that the Earth is bigger, and Jupiter is much bigger than the Earth, Sun is much bigger than the Jupiter, and there are so many stars which are bigger than the sun, and they all include in a galaxy, and there are millions of galaxies, and all those galaxies come together and form a universe. Now think how small we are in the universe. Are we like an ant dot? Not close. Now look at, to give you an idea of how we are in the universe, a picture is shown here. You will see, this is probably you. Can you relate yourself with the universe now? You are on the Earth. Earth is the part of the solar system. The solar system is part of the Milky Way galaxy. And the Milky Way galaxy is one of the million galaxies which exist in the universe. So think about the universe and the fact that it contains millions of such galaxies. How do you fit in the picture? We are just nowhere to be seen. Now this brings to the end of the chapter. There are so many things to discuss. There are exercises to be done. So I think the explanation was enough from this chapter. If you have any doubts, still you can text me. You can put a voice message to my personal number. And thank you. We will proceed with the revision and the exercises tomorrow.